Keeping up with our motto, let learning be a joy and teaching a pleasure. Here we are with the remote teaching and learning process to bridge the gap. Happy learning, students.
Subject Maths, Standard 7, Chapter 14, Part 2. Topic, Algebraic Formulae. Now, let us practice some sums for which the expansion formula we already know from previous part 1. We studied a plus b whole square equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. In these questions, use the given values to verify the formula for squares of binomials. Here the values of a is given minus 7 and value of b is given 8. Question number first, we substitute the values in the right hand side of the formula or left hand side, you can start anywhere. So first, a plus b whole square equal to value of a is minus 7, b is 8, minus 7 plus 8 we get 1, square of 1 is 1. Now next side, expansion is a square plus 2ab plus b square. Substitute the value of a, minus 7 square plus 2 into minus 7 into 8 plus 8 square. Square of minus 7 is 49 minus 7 2 are 14, 14 into 8 we get minus 112, 8 8 is 64. After solving this, we are getting answer 1. So you can observe, a plus b whole square also we are getting 1 and expansion a square minus 2ab plus b square also getting 1. Since both the values are same, hence a plus b whole square equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square is verified. Now next, a minus b whole square expansion formula. In this we already know that we have to substitute the value of a minus 7. And b, we have to substitute 8. Minus minus plus, sign minus will come. Minus 15 whole square. Minus 15 into minus 15, we get 225. Now expansion is there. A square minus 2ab plus b square. In a, we will substitute the value minus 7 square. Minus 2 into minus 7 into 8. B value is what? 8 square. Square of minus 7 is 49 plus 112 plus 64, we will get 225. Then again you observe that the value of a minus b whole square we get 225 and expansion also we get 225. Hence both the values are same, hence the expansion formula a minus b square equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square is verified. Now the same way, we have to verify the formula a plus b whole square and a minus b square for the value of a 11 and b 3. One I have already solved for you. This is the solution given, but you do by your own. Substitute the values. We substitute the value 11 and b value 3. We get 11 plus 3, 14. Square of 14 is 196. Again substitute the value of a, here we get 11 square plus 2 into 11, b value is 3 plus 3 square, 11 square is 121, this is 66, 3 square is 9, we add, we get 196. You can observe both the values are coming same, a plus b whole square also 196 and expansion is also 196. So hence the formula is verified. A plus b whole square equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Same way we will verify for a minus b whole square. A value is 11, b value is 3. 11 minus 3 is 8, 8 square is 64. We observed that a minus b whole square we get 64. We now find the expansion value. A square minus 2ab plus b square. Substitute the value. 11 square minus 2 into 11 into 3 plus 3 square, we get 121 minus 66 plus 9, we get 64. Hence, both the values are same. Hence, we verified the values for the expansion formula A minus B whole square also. Same way, you have to substitute the value A 2.5, B 1.2 in this expansion formula A plus B whole square. A plus B whole square, and in expansion A square plus 2AB plus B square, we see both the values are coming same. Hence, this formula is verified. Same way, substitute the values in expansion formula A minus B whole square. We get the value 1.69. In expansion also, you will substitute the value. We get the value 1.69. Both the values are same. Hence, we verified for the other expansion formula also. Now let us see some practice set questions using the formula A plus B A minus B equal to A square minus B square. First question, X plus Y, X minus Y. X plus Y, X minus Y. We compare this with the formula, expansion formula. Here value of A is X, value of B is what? Y. And we know that A plus B into A minus B is what? A square minus B square. So this will also become equal to X square minus Y square. Why? Because A value is X, B value is what? Y. So square of A means square of X, square of B means square of Y. Now here next, 3x minus 5, 3x plus 5. Here the value of A is 3x, value of B is 5. So it will become equal to A square minus B square equal to 3x square minus 5 square. 3x square means 9x square. Square of 5 means 25. Here next sum, A plus 6, A minus 6 will be equal to A square minus 6 square by using the same expansion formula which we used in our questions also. A plus B, A minus B equal to A square minus B square. Now square of A is A square only. Square of 6, we know that 6, 6 is 36. So it become A square minus 36. Now use the formula to find the values. 502 into 498. We know that 502 is nearest to 500. We have to select the nearest hundreds and thousand according to the question. Here 502 is nearest to 500. So we can write 500 plus 2 in a binomial form. 498 also we can write 500 minus 2. Here the value of A is 500. Value of B is what? 2. So we know according to formula A plus B A minus B equal to A square minus B square. So value of A we will substitute 500, 500 square. Value of B we will substitute 2, so it is 2 square. Square of 500 is 250,000. Square of 2 is 4. We will get 249,996. Same way we will solve 97 into 103. First you should see that 97 is nearest to what? It is nearest to 100. So if we subtract 3 from 100, we get what? 97. And if we add 3 in 100, what we will get? 103. Children, you should be very careful when you are selecting nearest 100 and writing that in a binomial form. Both the values should be same in both the brackets. A value should be same and B value should be same. Sign may be different. Here minus, here plus, or maybe here plus or here minus. But the A value and B value should be same. If they are not same, means something wrong you have written. Now here A is 100, B is 3. Therefore, 100 minus 3, 100 plus 3 equal to 100 square minus 3 square. So no need of getting confused why 100 square or 3 square comes, because we are using this expansion formula given below. A plus B, A minus B equal to A square minus B square. So here the value of A is what? 100. So we are writing 100 square. Value of b is what? 3. So we are substituting v. It is 3 square. 100 square means 10,000 minus 9. 9,991. Same way we will solve for 54 into 46. Here we have to see the nearest tens. So 54 is nearest to 50. So we can write 50 plus 4. And 46 is also nearest to 50. So we can write 50 minus 4. Because 50 minus 4 is what? 46. Here the value of A is 50, B is 4. So again we are using the formula A plus B, A minus B equal to A square minus B square. So 50 square minus 4 is square. Square of 50 is 2500 minus square of 4 is 16. We get 2484. Same way children, you solve this sum 98 into 102 using the same expansion formula A plus B, A minus B. We will get 100 square minus 2 square, 10,000 minus 4, 9,996. Now let us see what is factorization or what is factoring. Factoring is the process of finding the factors. You can see in the given example below, 6. 6 is having factors what? 2 and 3. 2 3 is a 6. So 2 and 3 are called what? Factors. Here in this expansion, x plus 3 and x plus 1, these are the factors of this expansion. Example, factor 2y plus 6. You can see in this 2y plus 6, we can easily understand that factor of 6 is 2 into 3. So what is coming common? 2. What is remaining inside? Y plus 3. So we can say that both 2y and 6 have a common factor 2. So 2y is 2 into y, 6 is 2 into 3. So we get the common factor 2 and y plus 3 inside the bracket right now. Same way, factor of 3y square plus 12y is there. You have to see that what is coming common. We know that 3 and 12 have a common factor 3. But we can also see that together they can they are having the variable y also common, so they can take common 3y. So 3y we have taken common and y plus 4 remains in the bracket. So the factors of 3y square plus 12y is what? 3y, y plus 4. Now 4x square minus 9. Here we can see 4x square minus 9. The factor of 4x square, instead of writing factor, first see that 4x square, 4 is square of 2 and x square is already given. So we can write 2x whole square and 9 is what? Square of 3. So we can write 4x square minus 9 equal to 2x square minus 3 square. Why it is necessary to write in this form? It is because we can use the formula then a square minus b square. If we are not making it in the formula form, then it is difficult to factorize. So if any question we can write that in a formula form, we have to do that. So if it is not making formula, then do the simple factorization. If it is possible to convert it into formula form, convert it into and then factorize. Here we can see that the value of a is 2x and value of b is 3. So a square minus b square will be equal to what? A plus b, a minus b. A is 2x, b is 3. So a plus b, a minus b, we get 2x plus 3, 2x minus 3. Now let us see some factorization sum. 201 a cube b square. So first thing, find the factors of 201. We know that 3 into 67 is 201. A cube can be written as a into a into a, and b square is written as b into b. So same way you have to do for 24, a square, b square and 91, x, y, t square. Already solved for you. Just write the factors of that. Thank you children. Have a nice day and practice the sums.